Mr. Young, you're recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and ranking member as well. An important conversation. This really does fit into the larger picture of how we address poverty in this country. So I'm glad that Mr. Lewis brought that up. It's such a multifaceted challenge, and of course, the program we're here to discuss today plays a very important role in that puzzle. The weakness of the family. I'd have to say, before I get into the immediate concern of this hearing, I think if we could get the economy to grow a little faster, that would alleviate so much. And I saw all heads nodding affirmatively on our panel when I said that. It would create more wherewithal so that we could fund these important programs, provide more hope and opportunity for people to perhaps incentivize them if they're not already searching for work, to go out and search more actively and just restore some hope and dignity and prosperity in this country, because we know those on the margins of society who benefit from many of these important programs are most adversely hurt during down economies. So reforming the tax code, the regulatory code, and so on are things that we really need to do. With that said, I know we're here today to discuss the implications of HHS's unilateral decision to waive work requirements from the TANF program. At a time when national poverty rates and welfare spending are very high, at least compared to recent history, Congress needs to ensure that those who need help are receiving TANF in a manner that provides a path to self-sufficiency, which includes ensuring that the job training programs that are out there are effective. But we must not waive requirements that have led to more jobs and earning, and also reduce poverty and welfare dependence. On that, I hope all of us can agree. Now, before the 1996 federal welfare law was signed into law by President Clinton, my home state of Indiana, under a Democrat governor, Evan Bayh, created work requirements for Hoosiers who receive welfare benefits. This ensured Hoosiers who were receiving benefits really got the benefits they needed, but we targeted this program towards those who needed the benefits most. As former Governor Bayh later said, the bottom line was trying to make someone self-sufficient. We were trying to achieve two values. One was the notion of community and also responsibility. So this is exactly, in my estimation, what the 1996 federal welfare reform law did, and is exactly what the Obama administration is undermining through this unilateral decision by HHS. So if HHS now claims they have the authority to waive work requirements, you know, I'm curious, and I'll direct this question to Ms. Brown. I know GAO hasn't conducted a legal analysis about the authority to grant these waivers unilaterally, but you did indicate that you've reviewed documentation showing that there's no evidence the administration has believed it had the authority in the past. So does this set us up on a sort of slippery slope here? What conceivably could HHS claim they could waive within the TANF program in the future?
I'm quite sure that our general counsel would advise me that I have to be very careful with this question. I think the issue
Please is, don't. Just be candid and forthright.
I think the issue is that what we saw when we looked at the records was a number of requests that states had made that were not necessarily grand redesigns. And during that process, HHS said again and again, different people, different levels, we don't have that authority, we don't have that authority. And then as the president issued a memorandum telling federal agencies to talk to states and locals about how to be more, to remove some of the burdens so that programs could move more effectively, they were hearing from states that they would like waivers, and HHS said they were beginning to think about whether they were revisiting whether they had waiver authority. That's as much as I know.
Well, that was a very carefully constructed response, but much appreciated, and I thank you very much for your testimony. I yield back.